Okay, it's time for the November 2020 Gardenside chat.
Yeah.
Hey boy, I'm back.
Good.
Finally, we have some people asking questions.
Yep.
Through questions, through commentary. Here we go. The die is cast. Who do we have? Okay, this is by a new entrant.
Okay.
Let's see, where should we put this? Same here?
Yeah.
Let's do it. This is by Wapom.
All right.
Jay Wins. Jay Wins. Wins. Jay Wins wants to know, just started my vegetable garden following Ida. That's Hurricane Ida. Any tips to help my cabbage and greens to grow fuller? Good question.
Yep.
Hat boy. See you later.
Alrighty.
Happy Thanksgiving to those of y'all in the United States who follow that. I'm gone.
Take care. Thanks, Howard. Okay, Jay Wins. Congrats on that win. So, I have a 10-point growing guide, planting guide, harvesting guide for amazing brassicas, of which cabbage falls under that category. So check that out. That's a comprehensive video from before even putting anything in the ground as far as seeds or starter plants, and all the way through harvest, and if you want to do long-term storage through the freezer, it covers everything. I am down here in zone 9A. Seeing as you're in Ida, I would guess that you're in one of these Louisiana zones as well. If not, just let me know, but it sounds like you're down here in Louisiana or perhaps coastal Mississippi. So there are two main points for right now that I want to mention as far as helping your cabbage and your greens grow fuller. One, you need acidic soil, and two, as far as fertilizers, you'd want a higher nitrogen content fertilizer over the potassium and the phosphorus. Not that you want something like you would do grass fertilizer. You don't want something that heavy, like a 24-00 or 46. You don't want anything like that. But you could use a balanced fertilizer, and then every so often give it a hit of, I use a fish emulsion. A particular one is a 5-1-1. It's 5 nitrogen to 1-1 potassium and phosphorus. The nitrogen, of course, helps out with the greening process, the growth process. That's what I do. I use that a bit more on my cabbages as well because it's mostly all green, whereas, say, your broccoli and your cauliflower, you're trying to get the flowering aspect of it as well. So, of course, like I always say for my any of the brassicas, the larger the plant, the larger the harvest will be. It perhaps goes without saying, but if you're seeing a small plant, don't expect a giant head to grow from it. That doesn't happen. You need large, wide plant to get a large head for that. So, and as usual, from those 2 points, compost. Compost, whatever it is, your homegrown compost, store-bought compost, whatever, aged manure, doesn't matter. Chicken manure would be good if you have it aged. That'll be good to scratch into the ground beforehand so you don't burn anything. So Jay Wins, thank you very much for that. Anna Walker, Miles Ford, thank you all for your questions. If you really want to know the answers to your questions, send me an email and I'll just send it to you directly. That's strawhatvideo@gmail.com. Okie dokes, if you want anything for December's Gardenside Chat, put in a commentary down below. Thank you all for watching. This is Grow Me Something, Mister. And remember, no, I don't have an exit on yet, so see you later, everybody.